women are frustrated by men's lack of acting and following conversation up with actions. And so are we creating kind of this atmosphere where we're encouraging men not to move or not to act?
Well, I think that's where we need to be really careful, because I do think a lot of women say, how can I open up that conversation to ask men how they want to be loved? I think it needs to end with a period there. Mm-hmm. If you want to ask men how they need to be loved or respected, then let that be your only motive. If your motive is for them to then come back and ask you how to be loved, then you're going to be disappointed. And so I think we need to go into going, Lord, I want to serve the men in my life, whether they're going to be my husband, my boyfriend, or just my friend, because I feel like I'm called to serve men and women. But I think maybe some guys are loved or respected in tangible ways, but it's going to look different for each guy. So you need to hear what they feel and then act upon it, and only be responsible for yourself and not ask for anything in return. Unless, of course, then it does move into a romantic relationship, you would hope that they would want to know that as well. Mm-hmm. But on the friendship level of just meeting your community of men, you can only be responsible for you.
Mm-hmm. And to go a different way with that question, I remember like the one of the major things that I remember from your parents' conference was that men enjoy side-by-side time with women and not the face-to-face. Mm-hmm. And if we want to love the men in our community, maybe a good way to do that is to not do that through conversation, but to do that through spending time with them in other ways. It's just engaging in activities with our communities.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
And again, it's not always true for all men, but I think we probably have interacted with guys and we know that there is some, for the most part, guys will open up. Like, I bike with a number of guys. Mm-hmm. And they will talk my ear off. They'll talk more than I do on bike rides, because I don't have enough stamina to talk and ride. But there is something about not having to have that forced eye contact. Mm-hmm. Guys can do it, but oftentimes they're more comfortable in the shoulder to shoulder. And I also notice I'll watch women ask men a question, and sometimes guys are slower verbal processors, and so then they're thinking about it, or they might not have even an answer in that evening. But girls sometimes aren't comfortable with silence, and so they'll like jump in and want to like keep carrying the conversation because they care. They want to make it comfortable and natural. But I think sometimes that's something to remember a little bit about most guys, is that they're a little bit slower, and just give them that space and they'll come back and they'll answer you, you know.
All I heard was guys are a little bit slower.
I don't mean verbal processors. Usually that takes them a little bit longer to articulate, but I have consciously been with men where I've asked them a question and I will wait to what I feel like is a painful amount of time of sitting in silence. They will answer.
And it's
they
often
do.
A good answer because they've thought about it.
Yeah.
Instead of just kind of this emotional, like, well, this feel. Is what I feel right now. It's like, oh, I'm thinking about this. And
yeah.
It's fascinating because we don't do that at all.
Yeah.
I guess another thing that I was thinking about was this whole idea. I've been hearing this whole concept over the past couple months, like this theme of I have a piece about something or I don't have a piece about something. Is that a church culture thing, do you think, the idea of having to have this piece before you pursue something?
Hang on there, Aaron. The answer to that will have to wait until part 3, when the ladies also discuss the pulp content of orange juice in different regions of the country.
Do you think that's, you know, like a Florida thing,